The Radeon RX 9070 and 9070 XT are almost here, and we finally have some official details on AMD's RDNA 4 GPUs, their specs, where they're aiming to compete, and their features. Will the RX 9070 family bring about a Radeon renaissance? Well, we're gonna know all about that right here, right now on Robeytech. AMD finally peeled back the curtain on its Radeon RX 9070 and 9070 XT GPUs in preparation for their March 6th release, and there is a lot to unpack. And since we got a first look, we wanted to take some time to pass along some of the things we learned, what AMD is claiming, and what they're not telling us about just yet. We got some official goals for the RX 9070 family, the differences between these two GPUs, where AMD sees them falling into their current hierarchy, and what FSR is all about, and whether or not you'll be able to get one for yourself on day one. And yes, there was a healthy heaping of shade thrown during the briefing towards NVIDIA as well. But right now, let's start with the elephant in the room. We don't have official pricing just yet. This was one detail AMD played very coy with during the briefing, but it's entirely possible that new information dropped as we were filming and editing this video. What we do know is that AMD did some research to see what price point most people are buying GPUs at. Where they landed was somewhere under $700. So that's where they're going to target, which is kind of a really broad target. Now, if these GPUs land in the $700 price range, does that mean we won't see partner cards go above $700? I guess it all depends on where MSRP lands, but smart money is on most likely, especially if MSRP cards fall anywhere close to the ceiling. That being said, what we are less likely to see, at least according to AMD, is scarcity. In the briefing, AMD shared that they are confident that their partners will have enough GPUs at launch to go around, hence the delay in releasing earlier. Is it true? I guess we're gonna find out when it launches on March 6th. Now, what's even more interesting and a departure from previous generation is that AMD is not releasing a reference edition version of the RX 9070 or 9070 XT. So it really does rest on the partners to get these GPUs into the hands of the consumer. With that in mind, expect to see both reference spec cards as well as overclock versions. And according to Hardware Unboxed, if they're $550, man, that would be awesome. But we just have to wait and see. So what is the reference spec, by the way, because I was talking about reference cards. Well, we're gonna slap the specs on the screen here for the RX 9070 family so you can see what we're talking about. Right up front, we have an 8 RDNA 4 compute unit difference between the RX 9070 and the 9070 XT, which impacts hardware AI accelerators and peak AI tops between the two. We also have a difference in power draw and frequency here, which obviously isn't surprising. What is interesting is that the 9070 has a lower power draw than the 7700 XT when you look at total board power, while the 9070 XT falls slightly below the 7900 XT. Now, when we look across the aisle, the 9070 XT looks like it's drawing slightly more power, kind of around 4 watts, than the RTX 5070 Ti, while the 9070 looks like it will draw about 30 watts less than the RTX 5070. This is where things get a little bit fuzzy because the GPUs are powering different architectures here. Not only that, both NVIDIA and AMD have their own terms for how they measure power. So this could not mean anything, but hey, data points, do with them what you will. Now, when AMD was asked about how the 9070 XT stacked up against the 7900 XTX, AMD say that in pure rasterization, that the 7900 XTX still wins, but in ray tracing, the 9070 XT has a stronger showing. Now, what we could be looking at when it comes to the 50 series comparisons is exactly what we're seeing teased with power draw. The 9070 XT could hypothetically go toe-to-toe with the RTX 5070 Ti, and if that's the case, depending on how close the RTX 5070 and RX 9070 get to their Ti and XT counterparts, we could see that whole thing line up there as well. What we do know is that the RX 9070 family is intended to perform at 1440p with some 4K capabilities, according to AMD. They did show some performance data that suggested that the 9070 XT was 4K capable without the benefit of upscaling. Now, we'll talk more about this all in a minute, but there is an elephant in the room that wasn't addressed in the spec sheet. What type of VRAM these GPUs will have? While both the 9070 GPUs have 16 gigabytes of VRAM, which is awesome, it's GDDR6, not GDDR7. Now, according to AMD, they kept the 9070 family at GDDR6 to balance cost and performance. Now, we'll have to see if it all pays off when we get them in our hands in our test benches later on in the week when we get them. I can't tell you, but you'll know when we come out with a review. And that brings us to insights into FSR4 and AMD AMD's approach to frame generation. Now, there are some of you that need to plug your ears here because you're not gonna like hearing this, but AMD is leveraging AI with FSR4. This is a machine learning-based upscaler that will be trained on AMD's Instinct accelerators before having those algorithms pushed out to the GPU. This actually starts to bring FSR more in line with DLSS, which has its upsides and its downsides. On the upside, there's a lot of potential for overall quality improvements with FSR, but on the downside, it looks like older RDNA GPUs will not be grandfathered into FSR4 support. So it looks like the 9070 family will be the "you must be this tall to ride" measuring stick for FSR4. That being said, AMD said that their FSR 3.1 support would become available to older GPUs and that the API is upgradable, so it's not kind of all doom and gloom here. AMD also did tease the term neural rendering, kind of like we heard from NVIDIA, but it wasn't a focal point. Maybe they were just trying to see how closely we were listening. Now, what AMD was a lot more vocal about was the 30 plus FSR 4 enabled titles that should be available at launch, with another 75 plus coming in 2025. That included games like Warhammer 40K, Space Marine 2, Horizon Zero Dawn and Horizon Forbidden West, Spider-Man Remastered, Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart, Call of Duty Black Ops 6, and more. But FSR wasn't the only feature AMD talked about improving with this release. They also talked about improvements in HyperRX, AMD's in-driver one-button performance tweaker, as well as the next evolution of AMD's Fluid Motion Frames, AMD's frame generation solution. Now, according to AMD, their focus with Fluid Motion Frames 2 is to enhance the quality of the generated frame rather than adding more overall frames to the party. It definitely makes sense for them to focus on this as a goal. After all, adding more of something doesn't automatically make that thing more awesome. That being said, there was a bit of a dismissiveness towards NVIDIA's DLSS multi-frame generation, saying that it felt like two-time frame generation was plenty and they had no plans to go beyond that. Now, it'll be interesting to see if this perspective changes in the future, but again, we kind of wait and see. But speaking of things AMD was not dismissive about, and I really was appreciative of this, they talked about their dedication to fixing the stability of their drivers. AMD acknowledged that they have some trust to earn with you, the gamer. So they've expanded their pre-launch testing, increased test configurations in their labs, and integrated AI-optimized internal testing. They're also adding features into AMD software like AMD Image Inspector, an opt-in feature that uses AI to monitor game frames and identify any corruption within them. They're also integrating AMD Chat, which is a local large language model that's entire job is to learn about your GPU and help you get more performance out of it. Which, I mean, it's so crazy, I think LLMs are funny. You can be stuff like, "Hey, help my GPU get better." And I mean, I'm not joking, that's really what it's for. Even with new hardware and an updated software feature set, AMD claims that the driver releasing with the RX 9070 family will be the most stable driver they've ever launched with a new RDNA GPU, which is awesome. And time will obviously tell. Again, these were all AMD's claims, and there were a lot of really big claims here. And again, the things we mentioned were just the features connected to gaming. We didn't even touch on improvements to creator and generative AI, improvements to their media engine for streaming and screen recording, quality bumps to their HVAC codec, or optimizing performance for programs like OBS and Handbrake. What we can say is that AMD set some goals for themselves that I think we all agree are great goals for them to aim for, and we absolutely want them to hit them. However, just like any press briefing or new product announcement, we'll have to wait and see if the claims are actually real and which ones are, you know, more aspirational. And hopefully we'll get to see what the RX 9070 family can do and whether or not it's a good upgrade for you. And I think this is where we're gonna end this one, because we wanna know what you think. Is AMD aiming for the right segment for the RX 9070 family? Judging by the features and where it looks like they're aligning, how much would you be willing to pay for one? And what do you think of AMD's statements about better than raw or near to raw performance with FSR4? Let us know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. And if you want to continue the conversations, maybe talk about what GPU might be right for you, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. It's an amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts about stuff like this. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us at Robeytech on all the other social media platforms. Thank you so much for watching this. We look forward to seeing you on the next one.